Jesus, Lord, we thank you. We praise you, dear God. And we appreciate you for your goodness and your mercy, Lord. We thank you for being our God and our Savior, first and foremost. We thank you for being everything that we need. We thank you for being our peace. We thank you for being our keeper. We thank you for being our provider and our healer, Lord. David said, what shall I render unto the Lord for all of his benefits? Lord, you are a benefit and a blessing to us. And so, Father, we thank you for allowing us to have jobs, to take care of ourselves and our loved ones, and we're bringing a portion back unto you. Lord, I ask that you would bless this offering, smile upon it, multiply it, even as you did the two fish and the five loaves, to where it is more than sufficient enough to meet the needs of those in need. Father, we thank you in advance for what you're going to do. I ask that you would open doors and make ways for anyone who is struggling in this seasoning. Anyone suffering from lack, I pray that you turn it around in the name of Jesus. Do what only you can do. We trust you with everything, oh God. In Jesus' name, amen. And you're on the direction of our usher. I'll know to direct certain things, and then you can also put a note if you give on Cash App or on an envelope, you know, for it to go specifically to a place, and then we make sure that it goes specifically to what you gave it for. Amen. Amen. So I want to thank you for what you have given in the mighty name of Jesus. With no further ado, God has sent my good brother, my bishop, all the way from the motherland. Amen. Somebody said, what's the motherland of the young people? The continent of Africa. Amen. I don't care what color you're from. If you go, you are. If you go back far enough, that's where you're from. Amen. So I'm excited. Amen. It's been about a year, maybe a little over a year since I've seen him. So we're grateful to be in fellowship with him today from the great country of Nigeria. Amen. So I want you all to receive Bishop Nwadika Augustine. In Jesus' name, amen. Put your hands together. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Thank God this morning. God is good. Thank God for the pastor. You have made it possible for me to be here.
Yeah.
Thank God every one of you. I'm from Nigeria, in Africa. The largest black nation in the whole world.
That's right.
I'm a young man. A young man of 78 years.
Amen. Amen.
Amen. You know, that's what I am now.
That's good.
Thank you, Jesus.
Bible said heaven and earth shall pass away, but a jot of God's word will never. And forever,
come
the
on.
Word of the Lord
yes.
is settled
That's right.
in heaven.
Come on, say
You may not believe it, but it is settled.
Yes, it is.
You may not accept it, but it is settled.
Yes.
That's God's word. And this word will never return back void.
Right.
Whatever God says he will do,
mm-hmm.
he will surely do it.
That's right.
God is not a man that he can lie.
Come on.
Cannot. Amen.
Amen.
Shall we all stand on feet as we pray? Father, we thank you again today. Heaven and earth shall pass away. The joy of your word will never. Bless us out of your word. Speak to us in a language we can understand. Bless us, heal us, set us free from every kind of bondage we're in. Let your word work in our lives and change us and make us what you want us to be. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Can you say, say amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
He must have preeminence in all things. Not in some things.
Come on now.
He must surely be number one in our lives.
Yes.
I want us to turn to the book of Colossians chapter 1. Colossians 1. Are you hearing me well?
Amen. Colossians 1.
Colossians. I'm sorry, I can't change my tongue.
That's all right.
You have to deal with me. I was not born here. Colossians chapter 1.
Right.
And the theme of the message is he must have preeminence in all things. He must be number one. We read from verse 15. Who is the image of the invisible God, the firstborn of every creature? For by him were all things created, that are in heaven, that are in the earth, visible and invisible, whether they be throne or dominion or principalities or powers, all things were created by him and for him.
Yes.
And he is before all things.
Yes.
And by him all things consist.
Yes.
And he is the head of the body, the church. Who is the beginning, the firstborn from the dead, that in all things he might have the preeminence.
Yes.
For it pleased the Father that in him should all fullness dwell. And having made peace through the blood of his cross, by him to reconcile all things unto himself, by him, I say, whether they be things in earth or things in heaven. And you, that were sometimes alienated and enemies in your mind by wicked works, yet now had he reconciled in the body of his flesh through death to present you holy and unblameable and unreprovable in his sight. If you continue in a faith grounded and rooted, grounded and settled, and be not moved away from the hope of the gospel which you have heard and which was preached to every creature which is under heaven, whereof I, Paul, am made a minister. God bless his word this morning in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. You can be seated. Thank God today for every one of us.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. I love this, and I want you to go home today with this word in all things.
Yes.
He might have what?
Preeminence
in all things.
He
must be number one in your life.
Yeah.
In all things. He must be number one in your family. You know, a family without him is not a family.
Right.
You know, business without him is not a good business. In all things, he alone must have preeminence. The Bible says, I want you to listen carefully. The Bible said, and he's before all things. It was God that was made flesh. In the beginning was the Word. The Word was with God, and the Word was God.
Yeah.
Verse 15 says, and this Word became flesh That's Jesus. God came in the flesh down here, this earth, to meet us as we were. That's why the Bible said, while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us.
Yeah.
He's number one in everything. He's the one that died for our sins. Nobody did that for us.
Hallelujah.
No president, no man, no woman did it for us.
Come on.
Jesus died for our sins. You know, and the Bible said he must be number one. He bought us with a price. We are no more of our own. We belong to him. He bought us. He paid the price on the cross of Calvary. That's where he died, was buried. On the third day he came out from the grave. He's alive.
Come on.
Can I hear a big amen?
Amen.
That's right.
He's our king.
Come on.
He's our rock. He's our fortress. He's our buckler. In everything, he must surely have the preeminence. He must be number one. In everything. The Bible says he is ahead and he's before all things. He's before all things. And by him, all things consist. By him. Whatever you are doing without him, you have not started. He's the Alpha, he's the Omega.
Come on.
He's the beginning, he's the end. When you have him in your life, you have everything.
Come on.
If you don't have him, you are empty.
Come on now.
Bible says Christ in you, the hope of glory.
Yes.
Christ in you, the hope of glory. The word of God says, not only that, the word of God says he's the head of the body.
Come on.
He's the head of the body. The body is not this building. We are the body of Christ. We are his body. We are his house. The Bible says we are the temple of the Holy Ghost. The Holy Ghost lives in us. We are his house. God is not living in a house built by men. God lives in us. Christ in you. Not building in you, but Christ in you. The hope of what? Glory. Christ in you. You have him in your life.
Yeah.
And he must be number one. He must have preeminence in your marriage.
Come on.
You know, any marriage without him will crash. It's not going to work. In your home, he must have the preeminence.
That's right.
Where you are walking, he must have the preeminence. Right. Anywhere you are, he must have preeminence because you are no more of your own. He bought you with what?
A price.
He bought you. He paid for you.
Yeah.
Yeah. He's your Lord. He owns you.
Come on.
Can I hear amen?
Amen.
To God. He owns you. The Bible says he's the beginning. He's the beginning and the first from the dead.
Mm-hmm.
He died, he resurrected, is our life. Every other religious founder, all of them died, but they're still in the grave. But Jesus died, he thought he came out from the grave. He's alive.
Yeah.
And because he lives, we shall live also.
Yeah.
Can I hear amen?
Amen.
Because he lives, we shall be. Live also. I shall be live also. Yes. You shall live also.
Yes.
Everyone here that have Christ shall live also. Come because on. He lives.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
That in all things, not some things, mm-hmm. in all things.
Oh,
mark that word there, in all things. Not some things, in all things.
Yeah.
In all things.
All things.
Touch your neighbor, say in all things.
In all things.
Touch him well.
In all things.
Touch him again.
In all things.
You are not touching anybody. Touch somebody.
In all things.
I said touch somebody. You just touch somebody. Tell him in all things. He must have preeminence. Preeminence means that he's number one. He's the first. He must be the first in our lives. Amen.
Amen.
He must, in all things, he must have preeminence.
Mm-hmm.
For it pleased the Father that in him should all fullness dwell.
Yes.
All fullness. Not some. Whatever you need is in him.
Yes, right. Yes.
Whatever you need is in him.
Yes.
The Bible says that he has been exalted. God has given me a name that's above every other name.
Yeah.
In the book of Philippians chapter 2, verse 9 and 10. Philippians chapter 2. Mm-hmm. Philippians chapter 2. I don't know, you know, you can help me. Philippians chapter 2. Have you seen it? Philippians, wherefore God also. I love this one. Wherefore God also had highly exalted him.
Come on.
Highly. That's why he must have preeminence.
Yeah.
God so much exalted. Highly. And has given him a name which is above. Hakabo Shatai.
Yes, Lord.
That's why Jesus.
Yeah.
Yes.
That's the one we worship, the one we serve, the one we follow.
Yes. Come on.
God, wherefore God also has exalted him.
Yes. Yes.
And has given him
hallelujah
a name which is above
my God.
Every name.
Every name.
Cancer, his name is above it.
Come on.
Sickness,
yes.
Whatever.
Glory.
Tumor, poverty, whatever.
Come on.
Name there. His name. Every
hallelujah
name must surely do what? Bam. A name is above every other name. Must have privilege.
Yes, he must. Come out.
He must be number one.
Thank you, Lord.
God, creator of heaven and earth, our heavenly Father, has given him a name. Our heavenly Father.
Yeah.
Exalted him above.
Yeah.
I am my
glorious. Yes, Lord.
So when you are serving him, serve him with all your heart.
Yes, my God. Come on. Come on.
Because there's no other name.
Mm-hmm. Hallelujah.
No other name that's above his name.
Yeah.
No other one that's above him.
Yes.
The one that made the moon, the stars, and everything exalted him, giving him a name above every other name. That at the name of Jesus.
Yes.
Not the name of Buddha.
Well, yeah. Come on. Come on.
Not the name of Muhammad.
Come on. Yeah. Come on.
But the name of who?
Jesus.
Call that name again.
Jesus.
Shout it.
Jesus.
Shout it like you believe it.
Jesus.
But the Bible says, whosoever shall call upon that name shall be saved.
Come on. That's right. Hallelujah.
Jesus. No matter wherever you are,
yes,
no matter your situation, no matter the challenges, no matter the sickness, call that name.
Hallelujah.
Call that name in the morning, call that name in the afternoon, call that name in the night, call that name at any time.
Yes.
That's why I say, call on me in the days of trouble, I will answer you.
Yes.
Call that name.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Woo! Hallelujah. My Lord. Lord.
Woo!
Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
My Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Oh, God. When sickness come, call that name. When disease come, call that name. When trouble come, call that name. When pain comes, call that name. Challenges of life comes, call that name. At the name of Jesus, every knee will bow. You know, Peter said to the lame man, said, silver and gold I have none but what I have. I don't have silver, I don't have gold, but there's something I have. I have the name of Jesus.
Come on,
he said, in the name of Jesus, stand up and walk.
Yeah.
That name's opened the blind eyes.
Come on.
That name raises the dead.
Amen.
That name makes a way where there's no way. That name brings favor. That name called Jesus.
My God.
Glory.
Glory.
The name of Jesus. That's why you must have preeminence.
Yeah.
In your life. Must be number one.
Yeah.
In whatever you're doing.
Yes.
That name. And that name every knee shall bow. Of things in heaven.
Yes.
And things in earth. And things under the earth. Mm-hmm. In heaven. All the demonic forces hanging up there. Mm. Bow at that name.
That's right. Yeah.
The ones here on this earth, no matter every kind of court, every kind of power, all bows in that name.
Yeah.
The ones under the water, under the earth, bows to that name.
Yeah.
There's no power that does not bow at that name.
Come on.
No one. Sometimes we don't know what we have.
That's true. Come on.
God gave us that name. Mm. We don't know what we have. That's why we're afraid whenever there's challenges. That's why we're afraid whenever sickness comes. Whenever disease comes. Whenever trouble comes, we're afraid. Not knowing what we have. That greater is he that's in she.
Come on.
Yeah.
And the devil
that's
in war.
That's right. Hallelujah.
What you have is she.
Yeah.
As a Christian. That's why if you are not born again, you're in trouble.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Especially living here on this earth with God Christ in your life.
Yeah. Glory to God.
Where will you run to? Which name can save you? Which power can help you?
Yeah.
Tell me. That name. That's why he must have. It's a must. Privilege
yes.
in your life, in my own life.
Yeah.
I'm from Africa, and I thank God for what is going on there.
Mm-hmm.
That's the only name that sustains us.
Come on, yeah. Come on.
All you have here, you have a lot of things here.
Yeah.
But when you know, I told people that in Africa we live by faith.
Mm-hmm. Come on.
Majority in America live by provision of the government.
Come on. Come on now.
Has provided, the government here provided a lot of things for you,
yeah.
but not so in Africa.
Yeah.
Our government is a mess. Our leaders are a mess.
Mm-hmm.
We know how to walk by faith. Yeah. We know how to live by faith. We know how to trust God.
Mm-hmm.
We know how to depend on God because we have no one to depend on than God.
Come on.
Yeah.
Today, in America today, you can depend in your Medicare. You can depend in anything. You can depend in tax reduction. Nobody does anything with your tax.
Mm-hmm.
If you pay your tax, you pay your tax, you're not going to get anything out of your tax.
Mm-hmm.
Are you hearing me?
No. Okay?
Yeah. Pay your tax.
Yeah.
At the end of the year,
uh-huh.
of the next year, you have what they call what?
Return.
Tax return. Then there's nothing like tax return. So if without God, you can live.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Without faith in him, you can't.
Come on.
My God, come on.
And sometimes it takes people that live in plenty to forget God.
My God.
People that are what? Living in plenty.
Right.
Forget God easily.
Mm. My Lord.
Come on.
We know how to look unto Jesus, the finisher and author of our faith. In him, God exalted him. God has given him a name above every other name. We believe in him for healings.
Yes.
In my name he shall cast out demons. We believe in it.
Come on.
In my name he shall lay hands on the sick. They shall be healed. We believe it. Whatever you ask in my name, that is according to my will, shall be granted unto you.
Come
we
on.
Believe it.
Lord.
In all things. Look at your neighbor again. Say, neighbor, in all things, let him have freedom. You know, that's why when Jesus was preaching, He preached something that was tough. And many of the followers left him and started going back. He never said to them, hey, come back. I'm sorry for my hard preaching. No. But he turned to his disciples, he said, will you also go?
Come on.
And Peter said, to whom shall we go to?
That's right.
You alone.
You alone.
Have the word. Because faith cometh by hearing.
Come on.
Yes.
Hearing the word of God. Am I right?
Yes.
Amen.
Faith.
Faith.
To believe in him.
Come on.
To trust in him. To depend on him.
Yeah.
God has highly exalted him. Salvation only is in that name.
Come on.
Acts of the Apostle, Acts chapter 4, 11 to 12. Salvation. Salvation is no other way than his name.
Right.
Acts chapter 4, 11 to 12. The Bible says there, then Peter, Acts chapter 4. Then Peter, filled with the Holy Ghost, said unto them, ye rulers of the people and elders of Israel, if we this day be examined of the good deeds done to this impotent man, by which means he is made whole. By which what? Means. By which means? You mean that other means? They are what? They are other means. You can get here by other means.
Yeah.
Yes, come on.
And they want to know the by which means this man was made whole. And Peter made a statement, be known unto you all and to all the people of Israel.
Come on.
By the name
of God. Yes. Come on.
By the name.
By the name. My God.
By the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, whom you crucified, whom God raised from the dead, even by him dwelt this man stand here before you whole. This is the stone which was set at naught by you builders, which is become the head of the corner. Neither is there salvation in honor. For there is none other name under heaven. Give it a moment. Whereby you must be saved.
That's right. Come on.
Yes, God.
There's no other name.
Nope.
Salvation is only through that name.
That's right.
Not through being a good man.
Come on.
Not your hand strength. Not out of your good works.
Yeah.
Salvation.
Not out of your prayers.
Come on.
Not out of whatever you are doing on your own to be saved.
That's right.
You can only be saved by that name.
That's
it. The one that died for you.
Yes.
The one that was buried.
Come on.
The one whom God raised from the
dead.
The one that ascended to heaven.
Come on.
And the one that is coming back again.
Yeah. Come on now.
Christ Jesus is
coming. Hallelujah.
This impotent man here, healed.
Come on.
They asked him a question, by which means? So there's no other means than his name.
That's the name.
Medicine can drugs, medicine can cure you. Yeah. But the name of Jesus cures better.
Yeah,
all right.
Because the name of Jesus takes off the root of every sickness in your life.
Yes.
Makes us whole.
Yes.
That name.
Hallelujah.
You know, that's why you don't need to backslide.
Come on.
You don't need that. You don't need to go back to the wall.
Come on.
You don't need that.
Say it.
And if you are still in the wall, come back to Jesus.
Yes.
Because he's the only way out.
Yes.
Can I hear amen?
Amen.
Can I hear big amen?
Amen.
There's utmost obsolete power.
Come on.
In that name.
I like it. Yes.
Absolute what?
Power.
Absolute power.
In that name.
Come on.
Yes.
In the book of Revelation, chapter 1, 7 and 8. Revelation 1, 7 and 8.
Uh-huh.
Woo! Glory to God.
My God.
Glory
to God. Hallelujah.
Mm.
Yes, God.
7 and 8.
Uh-huh.
Behold, he cometh with cloud. And every eye shall see him. And they also which pierce him.
Come on.
And all kindred of the earth shall well because of him. Even so, amen. Yeah. I am.
Come on.
Alpha.
Amen.
And Omega.
Yeah.
Yes.
The beginning.
Yes.
And the ending.
Yes.
Saith the Lord.
Yes.
Which is, and which was, and which is to come. The
Almighty.
Absolute power is in his hand. The book of Matthew said, all power. Oh, not some. Oh.
Come on.
Yeah.
Matthew 28. All power in heaven and earth given to me. That name Jesus.
Glory.
Come on.
Woo!
Come on, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord. Come on. Hallelujah.
Oh. Yo, right. I've followed him for 54 years now.
Yeah. Come on.
Come on now.
From 1970 to now. We're preaching this gospel of Jesus.
Yes.
And I can tell you, it can never fail you.
Yes.
No matter what.
Yes.
Say, come on to me. It's the only one that can say that. You can't say it to people. You can't say it to the whole world, come on to me.
Come on.
Yes. All of you that level and heavy laden, I will give you rest. You can't even tell it to people you are working with.
Right.
Because he don't have enough to give to them.
That's right.
But himself, Jesus Christ, have enough.
Come on.
Yeah.
Say, come unto me, all you that labor and are heavy laden, I will give you what?
Rest. Hallelujah.
Everyone here on earth needs rest.
Yes.
Yes.
We're living in a world where there's no rest.
Mm-hmm.
But only Jesus Christ himself can give you rest.
Come on. Rest. Come on.
Can give you peace. Say, my peace.
Yeah.
I give unto you.
Yeah.
Not as the world give it.
Yes, yes.
You can get your peace from getting drunk.
Lord.
By looking for women.
Mm-hmm.
By smoking.
Come on.
Mm-hmm.
But all of them are temporal.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Right.
It can't last.
Come on.
But when Jesus gives you peace,
all right.
The peace that passeth all understanding.
Yeah.
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 Thank you, Jesus.
Woo!
Glory to God.
Peace. It's not just drinking and smoking or eating.
No.
The real peace. The kingdom of God.
Thank you, Jesus.
The kingdom of God. It's righteousness.
Yes,
peace. Joy in the Holy Ghost.
Yes.
And he's the king of the kingdom.
Yeah.
He's a king of our kingdom.
Yes.
When we got saved, we are delivered from the power of darkness.
Come on.
Translated into his own kingdom.
Yes.
The kingdom of his dear son. The kingdom of peace. The kingdom of righteousness. The kingdom of joy.
Glory.
We are in the world, but we are not of this world.
Come on.
We are here for an assignment. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done here.
Yeah.
As it is in heaven. We are here for what? An assignment. To bring heaven down here.
Yeah.
And it happened first in our lives. When we receive Jesus into our heart, we receive the kingdom of God in us. The Bible said the kingdom of God is within you. The kingdom of God is in you. That's where it is. The whole creation are waiting for you to manifest.
Yeah.
Just like our Sunday school this morning.
Yeah.
They want to see Jesus.
Mm-hmm.
They want to see it through you and I. Mm-hmm. That's why God has committed the ministry of reconciliation into our hands.
Yeah.
So that we can reconcile all that to him.
Yeah.
That's our assignment.
Yes, yes.
Hmm.
Hallelujah.
I see you.
Yes, God.
I'm Alpha.
Yes.
I'm Omega.
Right.
The first and the last.
Come on.
The first and the last. He alone is the way.
Uh-huh.
He is the way
yes, he is.
To the Father. Not the way to heaven.
Uh-huh.
Jesus Christ is not the way to heaven. He's the way to who?
Father.
To the Father.
Come on, Father. Come on.
That's it.
He's the way to the Father. Mm-hmm. You know, we always say Jesus is the way to heaven. No. He's the way to the Father.
Good.
Amen. Because we lost our Father in the Garden of Eden.
Right. Yes.
When Adam sinned, we lost our Father.
That's right.
The whole world became a fatherless world. Jesus came to show us way back home. Mm-hmm. Without him, we can't get to the Father.
Come on.
I see.
Come on.
John chapter 14. John 14. Have you seen John? Not First John. John. Chapter 14.
Yeah.
They asked him a question.
Yeah.
Verse 5. Thomas said unto him, Lord, we know not whither thou goest, and how can we know the way?
Yeah.
And Jesus said unto him, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me.
Come on, amen.
That's it.
No man. As long as the Heavenly Father is concerned, no man cometh to him by that name. If you have known me, you will have known my Father.
Yeah.
And from henceforth, you know him, and you have seen him. Philip said unto him, Lord, show us the Father, and it is sufficient us. Jesus said unto him, have I been so long with you, and you have not known me, Philip? He that have seen me.
Come on, preacher.
I've seen who?
The Father.
He didn't say, here I've seen me, I've seen heaven.
Come on, come on.
You have seen the Father.
Yeah.
And that's why we that are born again, the Bible says, as he is, so we are here on this earth. We're not just born again to be praying and singing and dancing and jumping up and jumping down.
Right.
We're born again that people will see Jesus in us.
Yeah.
As he is, so we are. Not in heaven, here on this earth.
Amen.
That's why he made us ambassadors. We're here to represent him. Are you still here? Are you here?
Hallelujah.
Have you traveled? So that in all things, he will have the preeminence. In me, number one. He's the way. Not on the way, he's the truth.
Yeah.
Not that he was truth preacher. No, no, himself is the truth.
Come on.
Everything you want to know about heaven, about God, he is. He's the truth.
Yeah.
Is the truth about the true God.
Come on.
John 17.
Lord.
Verse 3. And this is life eternal, that they might know thee, the only. You know, the scripture is always specific. The only true God. Which means there are other gods.
Yeah.
You can make yourself a God. There are many gods today. But the only true God is our Heavenly Father.
Yeah.
the only true God, and Jesus Christ, whom thou hast sent. That name.
Yes.
The one he sent that came and recovered back what Adam lost. Jesus Christ came. That's why he was called the second Adam. Uh-huh. He came to restore back what the first Adam lost. Restore back our dominion over this earth.
Yes.
Born to rule. Who is he that overcometh the world? He that believeth that Jesus Christ, the Son of God, is a world overcomer. Are you catching it all?
Yes.
Can I preach more?
Yes.
Come on.
Yes, this is good.
He's a truth. Not only a truth, he's alive.
Yeah.
Jesus Christ is my life.
Come on.
Lord.
I have no other life than him. He gave us his own kind of life.
My Lord.
God has given to us eternal life.
Yes.
And this life is in his Son.
Come on. Say it.
1 John chapter 5.
Glory to God.
Are you still here?
Yes.
Do I read more scripture? 1 John chapter 5. And the Bible says,
glory to God.
I read from verse 10. He that believeth on the Son of God hath witness in himself.
Come on.
And he that believeth not God has made him a liar, because he believeth not the record God gave of his Son. And this is the record that God has given to us. God has given to me.
Yeah.
I don't know about you. Has he given it to you?
Yes.
God has given to us eternal life. Eternal life. Eternal what?
Life.
Not 100 years.
Come on.
Not 2,000 years.
Yeah.
Not 80 years.
My Lord.
80 years, 100 years, we are bragging and trying to live up to 100 years. Everybody's trying to live up to. For God said, no, that's okay for you, but I'm giving you something more than that.
Come on.
Woo! Glory to God. I'm giving you something.
Glory.
My Lord.
More than 100 years.
Yes.
More than 200 years.
Uh-huh.
I'm giving you my own kind of life. And this life is in his Son. He is a tree of life.
Yes.
He's the one God forbidden Adam to go and eat. Because if Adam eat it, no way for redemption again. Man will be a sinner forever. He drove him out of the garden. And the second Adam came. He said, that's the tree of life. He said, I'm the life. I'm the vine. You are the branches.
Yes, yes, yes. Glory.
In all things, he must have preeminence.
Yes. That's right.
Yes, Lord.
In all this.
All things.
He must have preeminence. Yes. Not in some things. In all things.
All things.
My Lord.
Giving us eternal what? Life.
Lord.
This life is in this Son. God has given us eternal life. And this life is in the Son. He that had the Son. You know, he said, I'm the life.
Yeah.
So if you have the Son, have my
Glory.
You have what?
Life.
And if you don't have the Son,
you have no life.
My Lord.
You know, all things he must be number one. God put all things in him. In all things, everything is in him, by him, and in him. Because the Bible says, in him we live, in him we move, in him we have our being. If you have revelation of what I'm preaching to you today, you go and buy toothpick. You know what toothpick is? Use it.
Yeah.
And relax and rest.
Come on now.
If you don't have it, you'll be troubling and be troubling and be troubling.
Yeah.
Say, in the war, you have tribulation.
Come on.
Be of good cheer. You know where the good cheer is? You know where?
Come on.
Where they're having a kind of form, they're having a kind of marriage, a wedding, and people will be holding their hand, and they say, cheers. And then Jesus said, do your own cheers when you have tribulation.
All right.
Be a good word.
Cheers.
Is that possible? Yeah. Do your own when there's what? Tribulation. Cheers. Not in a battle. Cheers.
Lord.
In the time of what?
Tribulation.
Be of good word.
Cheer.
For I have overcome the world.
Yes. Hallelujah.
Enjoy yourself. Rejoice. That's right. Was in prison and wrote to this outside prison, I say unto you, rejoice. Himself was where?
In prison.
He wrote to people that are outside prison and said to them, know what?
Rejoice.
And I say again, rejoice. Have a good cheer. No matter whatever you're going through in this world, for the joy of the Lord is our strength.
Hallelujah.
Oh God.
You like me?
Yeah. Good word.
So Bishop, you don't understand. I'm going through trouble. You have good cheer.
Alright.
Bishop, things are not working well for me. You have good cheer.
Come on.
Philippians chapter 1 verse 6 says, be confident.
Yes.
Come on.
Of this man, he had begun a good work. He started a good work in your life. You keep on walking in you and walking in you and walking in you until I know.
Thank you, Jesus.
You know, when I look at some people say, I'm tired, I'm sick, I don't want to go to church. I don't do this. I don't know. I'm so weak today. I'm going nowhere. You don't know what you are doing. Let the weak say,
I am strong.
Come on, yes.
Let the weak say, I am strong.
Yes. Come on now.
Say it.
I am strong.
When you are weak, say.
All right.
Come on.
Because he's our strength.
Yes, he is.
He's the strength of Israel. He's the strength of the church. Yes.
Come on. Yes.
Hallelujah.
These things have I written unto you that believe on the name of the Son of God.
Come on.
He that believe on the name of the Son of God, that you may know. Because if you don't know, you're in trouble.
Yeah.
That you may know. When you know that you know.
Come on.
That you may know that you have what? You have eternal life.
Yes, God.
That you may know. That you may know. I'm reading verse 13 of 7th John. That you may know.
You may Lord.
That you may know.
Yes, God.
If you don't know, the enemy will be playing on you. But when you know,
come on,
that you have eternal life. You know that?
Lord. Amen. Thank you, Jesus.
Please, can I get that verse 13? Yeah. These things have I written unto you.
Come on.
You that do what?
Believe.
That believe. On who?
On
the name.
There it is.
The name of who?
The Son of God.
That you may know that you have what?
Eternal life.
You have eternal life. And that you may believe on the name of the Son of God.
Come on, come on.
That you may know that you have eternal life.
Come on.
Yes.
You have to know. You got to know. You must know.
Come on.
That you have God's kind of life in you. That's why you don't play with sin.
My Lord.
Amen. That's why you love righteousness and hate iniquity. Mm-hmm. You love what God loves and hate what God hates.
My Lord.
That's why you love to love God and love man.
Yeah.
Be a blessing to people.
Yeah.
Because you are called for that.
That's right.
That's right.
Don't be selfish.
My Lord.
If God is blessing you, like he said to Abraham, I'll bless you, and then you turn around and be what? Bless. Be a blessing.
Yeah.
Be a blessing, yes.
God is love. We are born of God. We have the DNA of God. We are born of God.
Yes.
We're not just ordinary people. No, no, I'm not. I'm here sent by God for our assignment.
Yes.
To do God's will here. To set the captives free.
Come on.
To lose those that are bound.
Yes.
To feed the poor. Your pastor knows that. All we do in Africa is feeding the poor. He knows that. Widows. Helping others. With the little we have. Because when you eat alone, you die alone. Hello?
Amen.
I see that you may know you have what? You have eternal life. And this is the confidence that we have in him.
Yeah.
Oh my God.
Come on.
The what? The confidence that we have in him, that if we ask anything according to his will, he heareth us.
Come on now. Thank you, Lord.
We serve God and answers prayer. As long as we are praying according to his will.
Yeah.
And the Bible says, he heareth us.
Oh, God.
And if we know, we know, if we know, if we know,
come on.
If we know, if we know that he hears us, whatever we ask, we know that we have the petition that we desire of him.
God.
We know.
Yes.
You know, we don't serve God just harvesting. No, no, no. We serve God from our hearts.
Yeah.
We love him from our heart because he first loved us.
Yeah.
The Bible says he loved us. We love him because he first loved us. He saved me. I was a sinner. Bad one. Chief one.
Yeah.
You know, Paul said that he was a chief sinner.
Yeah.
He saved us.
Yes, God.
So we have to come back again to do what? To love him.
Yeah. Yeah.
And then when we love him, we look for others we're going to save too.
Yeah.
And then whatever we ask him, God hears prayer. God wants us to be prayerful.
Yes, God.
That's why he put the Holy Ghost in us. When we don't even know what to pray, the Spirit of God help us to pray. We pray for all men. We pray for those in authority. We pray even for our enemies. We love our enemies. Mm-hmm. We hate their sin. Mm-hmm. But we love them.
That's right.
We forgive people so that God will forgive us.
Yes.
If you don't forgive, your heavenly Father will not forgive you.
That's right.
We forgive people. We love people.
Yes.
We help people. We serve people.
Yes.
The Bible says how God anointed Jesus Christ of Nazareth with Holy Ghost and with power that went about doing what?
Good.
Yes.
And now God has anointed you so that you keep on going around doing good. Because you are now on his team. You are representing him here on his face. The same Holy Ghost that came on Jesus is on us.
Yes.
Woo.
Good.
Mm.
My God.
Ah.
My Lord.
Yeah, my child.
Lord.
He's interceding for us. Jesus is our right hand of the Father.
Mm-hmm.
Interceding.
Hallelujah.
For us. He's our mediator. He's in between the Father and us. Interceding for us.
Yes, God.
His blood still speaks for us.
Yeah.
The blood of Jesus speaks better things than the blood of Abel.
That's right.
The blood of Abel calls for vengeance. The blood of Jesus calls for forgiveness.
Yes.
Father, forgive them.
Thank you, God.
They don't know what they are doing.
Mm-hmm.
That's why if we confess our sin, God is faithful and just to forgive us.
Yes.
That's why the blood of Jesus keeps on cleansing us, purifying us, making us holy and clean. The blood is there.
Come on.
Don't run away from him. If you have made a mistake, don't run away. Come to him.
Come
the blood is available.
Yes.
The blood still speaks for us.
Glory to God. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you.
Praise the Lord.
Yes.
Praise the Lord.
Thank
you. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. We serve a God
that
cannot fail.
Yes, thank you, Jesus.
Himself took our infirmities.
Yes, Lord.
Himself bore our disease. By his stripes we were healed.
Yes.
Himself was made poor so that we'll be rich. Himself. He was made a curse so that the blessings of Abraham will come upon us.
My Lord.
He was made sin. He became a sinner so that we will become God's righteousness. The righteousness of God. He imputed his own righteousness into us.
My God.
That today we can talk to our Heavenly Father.
Yes, Lord.
In all things, he will have the preeminence.
Yes.
If you have not given your life to him,
yeah. Do
it. Ask him to come into your life.
Yes.
Be at peace with him. Jesus came to reconcile us back to our Father.
Yeah.
We have an heavenly Father. That's why he said, when you want to pray, pray this way, our Father, which art in heaven. Our Father. We have a loving, kind, compassionate Father. Our Father is good.
Yes.
I don't look at what's happening in the Old Testament. No. But I look at things that happen in the New.
Mm-hmm.
No one has ever seen the Father.
Mm-hmm.
When Jesus came, he said, this is your Father.
Come on.
Come on.
Hallelujah.
He forgives sinners. No matter how your sins are.
Thank you, Jesus.
He said, the captive is free. No matter what you have done. He said, I love you. I created you in my own image.
Thank you, Jesus.
I want you. The Pharisees were crying, shouting. He has gone into the house of a sinner. He said, that's why I come. I do not come for the righteous. I come for sinners.
Yeah.
He so loves us. He's so kind.
Yes.
If you are thinking of going back to the world, don't go. Keep standing. Keep serving.
Amen.
Keep following.
Amen.
Look for others. Draw them to Christ. Reconcile them to Jesus.
Yes, God.
He's the hope of the hopeless.
Yes.
Christ is you, the hope of glory.
Yes.
Shall we pray? If you want me to pray for you, you want to turn your life to Jesus, or you are sick, can you just come forward here? I want to pray. Want to turn your life to Christ? Want me to pray for you? And you are sick, you want me to lay hands on you? Can you come forward here? I want to pray for you. You want to rededicate your life to God? You can still come forward. Yeah? Come forward. I want to pray for you. Hilabo Shataya. Hey, Alabushana Lavahaya. Hey, Kama Satai Labushana
Lavahaya.
Oh, Jesus, we love you. We love you, Lord. We love you, Lord. We love you, Lord. Father, we love you, Lord. We love you, Lord. We love you, Lord. Abba, we love you, Lord. We love you, Lord. We love you, Lord. Jesus. If you have not received him, ask him to come into your life. If you are sick, ask him to heal you. His power is present here to heal. No matter what, his power is here to heal you. His power is here. Ask him to come into your life. He's still doing a life-changing business. He can turn you from a sinner to a saint. I break the bonds of the enemy over your life and loose you from every satanic bondage in the name of Jesus. Be very whole and be free from every torment of the wicked in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Name of Jesus. 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 I bless your soul. Name of Jesus. The power of our master in your life. And make you completely whole in Jesus' name. Amen.